We live. Week 15. Sheesh.
Today, it's Madden NFL football. It's week 15 of the NFL on EA Sports. Deshaun Watson and the Cleveland Browns taking on Lamar Jackson and the Baltimore Ravens.
We are just off the shores of Lake Erie in downtown Cleveland, Ohio, as we get set for football here at the always rocking Cleveland Browns Stadium. Today on to week 15 in the NFL, and we've got a good matchup in store as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Cleveland Browns.
It's a dog fight. Sheesh.
Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Browns ball club. They've been playing well, really well. Winners of five of their last seven, but losers last time out. Justin Tucker set to bring this one away. And off we go from Cleveland. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. So here come the Browns for their first drive on offense. They will be led out by their dual threat quarterback, the veteran from Clemson. It's Deshaun Watson.
And what I loved about meeting with him before the game was talking to a guy who takes ownership of his performance. Two touchdowns, two interceptions last week, but all he focused on was the loss, okay? And he did say, if I change my stats a little bit, not necessarily for me to look better, but that'll help my team.
They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line.
Damn, Nick Chubb a beast.
Check out the numbers for Chubb from a week ago. 13 carries, 74 yards, and a touchdown.
When you put the ball in the end zone 13 times on the season, one thing is apparent. You didn't do it all on your own. Offensive line is creating some nice space for you, and you probably get some good blocks downfield from your wide receivers.
Ball on the 36 now. Here's second and three. Chubb on the counter. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, and now they go from second and two to a tough third and four. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. To throw is Watson. The ball comes out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Deshaun Watson, so multi-dimensional, able to scramble for the first. They go up the middle with Chubb, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Well, this defense for the Ravens, they were very good in the victory a week ago over Cincinnati.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Yeah, look at this Baltimore defense. It's quite a unit, that's for sure. Number one in the NFL against the pass.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB, they'd easily move into the top five.
On first down, it's Watson. Caught here by Bell. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Holding, coming back.
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they do a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Now Watson. This complete to David Bell. He is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
God.
14 yards, and it's a Cleveland first down. Watson.
Well,
he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Massages.
Picked up by Rogiesen. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a running touchdown. Well, just an excellent play there by the defense to not only pick it but take it back, because Charles looked like they were in a groove passing the football several completions.
He's trying to get a contract.
They certainly did appear to be locked in, and with how this offense is moving along, I know we certainly didn't expect to see a pick to end the series. Whatever the cause was, maybe they tipped one of those scripted plays. Maybe the defender just made a great read, but it certainly quickly changed the tone of this one.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This taken in at the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Second drive coming up here for Cleveland as they return to the field on offense. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's
all right, come on, Watson. Do what y'all did against
the
Eagles.
The pick six, and you come right back out on the field. You know,
about to get blown out.
You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to
attack. Damn.
There we go. There we go.
I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain. Here's Chubb on the read option. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
Here's the new Chubb.
You can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I know Coach told me before that he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip them.
There he goes, Amari Cooper. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 31-yard line. 23 yards the pickup there. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 down at the 31. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted.
Oh my God, he is doing another damn thing.
And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
My roots.
So a nice play defensively. Rookie coming up with the INT.
And that's a late round pick right there, making a first round impact. And a lot of these day three corners end up winding up on special teams and sub packages and even on the practice squad. But he's really made an impact on this defense, and he comes up with the interception there.
Come on, Denver. I need y'all to beat the Steelers.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Flowers going to go in motion right. Now Jackson taps this forward. Jet sweep down inside the 10. And the Ravens are going to have a first and goal as he's inside the 10 down to the 7-yard line. Just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line,
they'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens
touchdown. Ball not fast enough.
Lamar Jackson taking it in from 7 yards away.
This what they did against Joe?
It look easier because AFC teams can struggle out here.
Quick work of it. Just two points to get into the end zone. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
Used to saying none.
Oh, yeah, true.
He takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26.
They in my divisions, though.
Ready to go. And job one here, Charles. Just keep possession of football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. If the crowd goes, first do no harm. But right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. 14-0 to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. To the second from Cleveland. It's the Browns in control of the football as they are looking at a second down and 6 coming up. They run it again with Chubb. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 14 yards and it's a Cleveland first down.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. Another down a couple of
oh
yards.
My God.
The running game worked in that situation.
Look at my relief.
Go in that direction.
Get his bitch ass.
Players combined for their team's first sack of the game. Well, you're already up a couple of scores here in the first half defensively, and Charles, they just seem to be playing really free on that side of the football.
I love the observation because with that type of a lead,
they can take a few more chances
and be even more aggressive, and it's been paying off for them so far this game.
Ooh.
On second down, here's Watson. It's incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Throwing on third down, Watson. Going out wide, finds Chubb. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. The Browns send out their punter.
Watch the fake.
As he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. They'll call that a 33-yard punt with no return. And the Ravens will get it. First and 10 from deep in their own territory. Baltimore set to take over here for their second possession of the game. And the stakes in this game certainly high as we get toward the end of the regular season. For now, they are holding a wild card spot, but there are no shortage of other teams in the NFC looking to take that spot from them.
Starting with the guys on the other side of the field because they're on the outside looking in, and no one likes to be in that position. You want to be in the room, not looking inside to see everyone else having fun.
From the 17, here's second and 4. Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And Andrews going to have a Ravens first down as he'll get this to the 23-yard line. Jackson now. That's complete to his receiver, Bateman. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 12 yards to pick up there. Good for a Raven first.
Watts, a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? And Jackson going to have the first down as he will get to the ground to avoid the contact. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. The Ravens at 8-5 to start play. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Options galore here, second and a few inches. They go play action with Jackson, rolling to his right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
It's a gain of four there and gives him a new set of downs. Now it's Jackson. A short throw caught by Andrews. And the result here, a pickup of eight.
But yeah, what? Own it.
Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpire's got different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
2 minutes to play, first half, it's 14-0. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Right back to Dobbins on first, as he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. 9 big yards on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Meanwhile, Jackson's throw complete there to Bateman. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down. Here's Jackson to throw. That one tipped, and it's incomplete. But good hands there defensively at second down. Now a second and 10. Here's Jackson. And this is going to be intercepted. And the Browns are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Until December, but congrats to the rookie, his first INT.
Yeah, he's been a reliable contributor for this defense throughout the season. Definitely got a bright future, and has gotten even brighter after making that play.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Now a dump off here complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Now the Browns will use the first of their 3 timeouts, as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. 2 yards to go, second down. Now it's Watson. And that is taken in by Njoku. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts, as the clock stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. So a big play as it gets them all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. From the red zone now, Watson. He's got the connection to Cooper. Touchdown, Browns! Amari Cooper with career touchdown number 75. And the Browns are on the board here in the first half. Extra point splits the uprights, and that'll make our score 14-7. The Browns kicking team out there now as they'll send this one away. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Football back over to Baltimore and J.K. Dobbins. A 1,000-yard campaign in his sights, Charles, but needs a little bit of a kick here down the stretch to reach it.
And sometimes at this stage of the season, you're looking for that extra goal, right? That extra motivation to accomplish what you want, not just as a team, but as individuals. He's got to stretch a little bit to get there. That might be what they're talking about during the practice sessions in their meetings. Hey, we can still get this done. Let's go ahead and feed him the ball.
And the offensive line, I'm sure they're well aware of where he stands as well.
They are, and I think for them, it would be an even better accomplishment to get there now because it seems like a little bit of a reach.
That's a 12-yard gain now on back-to-back plays. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Throwing is Jackson. A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. So how about this for field position?
Why is it lagging now?
Big play inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Touchdown! Andrews, as the first half is winding down, and the Ravens would extend their lead here just before halftime. So they get their tight end away from the line to the outside, and he works his way in for six.
Tight ends are not just blockers anymore. I don't know how many more times we need examples, but here's a great one. Gets to the outside, they give him the ball pretty quickly, and they trust him to get those extra yards, and boy, did he come. Nice catch.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and it's now 21-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. And with only 9 seconds remaining, and not much time, we'll see how they play this. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. The final shot before the break, Watson. Oh, Cooper with a nice grab. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Ravens out in front as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, time for a sprint to the finish, as it's time to get you caught up with what's happening around the NFL here in a pivotal Week 15. We'll begin up in the Still City, Acrisure Stadium in Pittsburgh. And it's the Steelers out in front in the second quarter. Kenny Pickett has thrown a touchdown pass. From there, we head down to sunny Miami to check on the Dolphins at home at Hard Rock Stadium. And they currently trail in that game against the visiting Patriots. Mac Jones with a couple of touchdown passes. Lastly, we head to the Gulf Coast and check on the Bucks at home in Tampa. As you can see, the score there in the second quarter. A couple of touchdown strikes there from Sam Howell. In the game you're watching, we've seen a strong first half out of Lamar Jackson. His guys have a 2-touchdown lead as we hand it back over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
right, Coach. Thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
And they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
Now Dobbins again on second down. Only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
That's taken in by Duvernay. Room here to run. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A big play that time on the catch and run. And it's going to yield a new set of downs.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
So the completion good for just three. And it's second down. Jackson steps away to his left and seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion wise way up. Not that time. Open man is Duvernay. And he's taken down inside the 30. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
Jackson throwing once more. A short throw caught by Andrews. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Off the play fake to Dobbins, here's Jackson. Forced out to his left. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. On third down, Jackson being chased out left. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
And Brandon, this is the time of the game when Jackson could really take over. He's got the defense's legs a little bit tired. He's got them on the run.
Yeah, this defense looks gassed, and you're exactly right. Second half with the lead, this is when Lamar Jackson seems to thrive. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. Flowers going to go in motion right. Now Jackson taps his forward jet sweep. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one.
Oh, my gosh.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. Now after the holding call, here's second and 20. Bateman, and he'll go in motion right here. Now Jackson taps his forward jet sweep, and he'll keep it moving down to the 15-yard line.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. To throw is Jackson. A man, and he hits him in stride. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Devin Duvernay, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical is one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, you mentioned that slowly but surely, you also drain clock too with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. From his end zone, here comes Jerome Ford. And he returns this to 22. The Cleveland offense ready to go. They begin this drive with Chubb. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
It's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
On second down, here's the option. Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it. And it's picked up.
How is he thinking?
And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
And this is one of the dangers of letting your quarterback run the football. Look, he comes to ball security drills just like a running back does, but most of the time the quarterback swings the ball away from his body, and in traffic, sometimes they forget to protect it.
And now Baltimore gets set to take the field.
The box is catching the ball.
Now you've got the down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game, yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Going for it all. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
So the fumble recovery had them set up in ideal field position, but they can muster only 3 points out of it.
Yeah, when you're able to force turnovers, especially when it results in field position like they had, you really want to make it hurt. Here, they take the field goal. That's definitely not what they were hoping for.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble, bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Browns drive about to get started. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand.
Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it, and it's picked up by the Ravens. Inside the 20. And this is going to be brought back for a Baltimore touchdown. Huge, huge play by the defense, not only to force the fumble, obviously, but to return it for a touchdown.
And I know it's no fun for anyone who plays offense, but isn't it fun to see how a defense rallies when there's a fumble return and everyone tries to find someone to block and bring it all the way home?
I always like their celebrations because they don't get there that often.
No, they're not choreographed very well usually.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score.
Downstairs.
And the tackle will be made right there at the 25-yard line.
Boy, Deshaun Shackner.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. We haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD. And if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here and maybe beating the traffic in order to get home to their final destination?
I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Watson now to throw. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up 2nd.
But one thing I do know, these guys on defense, they don't want this game to end. They're winning by multiple touchdowns. They've shut down the opposing quarterback in a big way, and they're still picking up sacks as we approach the end of this one.
Here's Watson now on 2nd down. And a quick throw there is incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
And he gets this early to the 41, not near enough for the first. It'll be a gain of 12, but it will also lead to 4th down. Watson gonna stay out there as they'll go for it on 4th. Desperation time, Watson on 4th down, and it's gonna be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. The Browns unable to move the chains on 4th down, and the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. Well, they've clearly made a conscious decision here to be more aggressive in the late stages of this game here in the second half.
And I get it. In this situation, you know, if you want to be aggressive out near midfield, you feel good about your defense maybe, or just, hey, I thought I had a proper play call. But how about the guys that just stopped them? How good do they feel right now? Hey, you want to go for it here? If we shut you down, they're over on the bench right now feeling great.
On 1st and 10, it's Dobbins. And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's 2nd down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Duvernay in motion. And they're going to give it to him on the jet sweep. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a 3rd and about 4 more for a 1st.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
The Ravens on 3rd down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 4. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's 4th down. The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
Watson and the Browns now with a 1st and 10 at their own 22. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's got Njoku over the middle. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the 1st. On 1st and 10, Watson. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Adafe Owe showing off the pass rush skills.
We all know he's one of the better quarterbacks in the league, but definitely not today. His team trailing by multiple touchdowns and a late sack. Just a parting gift from the defense for him to take back to the locker room with him.
Out of the gun, Watson. This short pass into the hands of Njoku. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
Watson, that's complete. It's Elijah Moore. And he is going to have a Browns first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of six. And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the two-minute warning. Watson on first down. This is the tight end, Njoku. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. A shotgun snap for Watson. Tries the right side and he finds Bell. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Right back to Bell, and it's caught once again. Yeah, the Browns are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next.
And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
Extra point right down the middle, and the lead is down to 24. So that drive goes eight plays, and the final act belonged to Deshaun Watson in his touchdown run. Fair catch called for and taken back near the goal line, so that'll come out to the 25. And Baltimore's offense set for this next possession. They're looking at a third straight win here if they can hold on. They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Second and six, just inside the 30. And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. 27 yards there, a first down. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number four in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
58 yards rushing for him now to this point. They go play action now. Jackson flushed out right. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And maybe more importantly, a victory in the division, which always helps.
And on the road. How about all of that rolled up into one? Because how often do you see division games get decided by this much of a margin?
Most times, they thumped them.
Yeah, they jumped all over them. And a division game is usually a touchdown or less because these two teams know each other better than most teams in the league. In this case, that didn't hold up. On the road, big margin, big victory. Oh, yeah, that flight home will be good.
So for the Ravens, the final 3 weeks are going to tell the story as they move to 9-5 on the year. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for Cleveland, they fall to 8-6 with the loss. And they'll try to rebound next week on the road in Washington. Effort.